Emmanuel Macron making that first state visit to Tunisia. He's made private or working visits, as they're called, to Morocco and Algeria. Tunisia, he says the fact that this is a big official state visit is to show support for the democracy there. Has France shown enough support for Tunisia's democracy?
No, I don't think so. I think this visit is very important, very well timed, following the recent protests and given the current lack of political and economic progress in Tunisia. There's been a lot of discussion online surrounding Macron's visit about how Macron can't solve Tunisia's problems. And it's true, he can't solve them on his own. But it's very clear that this visit comes at a very important time, and Macron can do a lot, not just directly in terms of investment and student visas and other things, but symbolically. There are investors who've been holding back from Tunisia. There's a lot of questions about stability in Tunisia. So there are many levels, including symbolically, where the French visit is very important.
Symbolically or not so symbolically, one of the things that might bolster investors, they say, is the security situation and making sure the border with Libya is safer. Should France be doing more?
Absolutely, and there's a lot France can do and has been starting to do. And certainly, we've seen, for example, France's participation in European Union level efforts to address illegal migration off the Tunisian coast and off the Libyan coast. Certainly, France has been helping with the relatively porous border in the south of Tunisia. So there are a lot of things France can do in terms of security cooperation, in terms of monitoring, in terms of taking care of refugees. And certainly, given the mood in Europe these days, like the mood in the United States regarding migrants and refugees, it's very important that France hits the right notes. And let me just add, France has not been as supportive as they could have been since the Arab Spring. And right from the very beginning, they said some sort of unhelpful things vis-à-vis the revolution. So it's important that France address Tunisians and address Tunisia in a respectful way, in a supportive way, and in a way that signals that France will stand by Tunisia in every way possible in its difficult moment.
Well, let me ask you about the debt relief question, because actually that it goes beyond France, of course, but the feeling of there's a feeling of resentment among some Tunisians saying the French should be fighting our corner a bit more when it comes to big lending institutions like the IMF, which have forced through these costs, which have, with these loans, have forced through, in a way, indirectly, these cost of living increases for ordinary Tunisians.
Yeah, given Tunisia's fiscal problems and an impending fiscal crisis, it would be very easy for national lenders to bury Tunisia in debt. And this needs to be avoided. France has a positive history of excusing African debt, former colonial debt, in favor of investment. And there's some anticipation that over these 2 days of during the visit that Macron will make announcements of converting some of this debt into investment. But I find it curious that France, Tunisia's strongest trading partner, is the second biggest investment after United Arab Emirates. And there's certainly a big upside to what France could be doing, both on the fiscal side and on the investment side. And certainly, France hasn't played all of its cards towards the Arab world's only democracy.
He's come with business leaders, including the internet entrepreneur Xavier Niel. Daniel Hoffman, let me ask you on this score. Tunisia is that country in North Africa that has a nascent services industry. What's the potential?
I'm assuming this question's for me. Yes, Tunisia has a big potential upside. It has a highly trained population. It has excellent education relative to a lot of the other countries in the region. And there's no question that Tunisia could play a much larger role in services towards Europe. They've got the languages, they've got the technical capacity, they've got the professionalism. So there's a big upside there. In fact, I don't think enough has been done. And certainly the Germans have shown how investments in these areas in Tunisia can pay well. And I don't think France has invested as much as it could have in these areas. So it's very important that Tunisia, you may remember, way back in the 1980s, had the best was best positioned in terms of the internet. And during the dark years of Ben Ali, he basically killed the internet in Tunisia. And now it's on the rebound. And given the freedom and the openness and the skills that Tunisians have regarding social media, regarding the internet, there's a huge potentiality there.
William Lawrence, who teaches at George Washington University, many thanks for being with us.
My pleasure.
Stay with us.